ओ भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
चैप्टर
शुक उवाच श्रीशुक उवाच आत्ममायामृते राजन्
आत्ममायामृते राजन्
पुरस्यानुभवात्मनः
पुरस्यानुभवात्मनः
न घटेतात् सम्बन्ध
न घटेतात् सम्बन्ध
स्वप्न
द्रष्टुरिवाञ्जसा
बहुरूप इवा भाति
बहुरूप इवा भाति
मायया बहुरूपया
मायया बहुरूपया
रममानो गुणेश्वस्य
रममानो गुणेश्वस्य
ममाहमिति मन्यते
ममाहमिति मन्यते
द्यारिवावमयिम्निस्वे
परस्मिन् कालमायो
रमेत गतसम्मोहस् रमेत गतसम्मोहस् त्यक्तबोधास्ते ततो भयम्
त्यक्तबोधास्ते ततो भयम्
आत्मतत्त्वविशुद्ध्यर्थम्
आत्मतत्त्वविशुद्ध्यर्थम्
यदाह भगवान् ऋतम्
यदाह भगवान् ऋतम्
ब्रह्मणे दर्शयन् रूपम्
ब्रह्मणे दर्शयन् रूपम्
अव्यलीकवृतादृतः
अव्यलीकवृतादृतः
आदिदेवो जगताम्बरो गुरु
आदिदेव जगताम्बरो गुरु
स्वाधिष्ण्यमास्ताय सुशिक्षयैक्षत
स्वाधिष्ण्यमास्ताय सुशिक्षयैक्षत
धाम्नाध्यगच्छ दृशमत्र सम्मताम्
धाम्नाध्यगच्छ दृशमत्र सम्मताम्
प्रपंच निर्माण विधिर्जया भवेत्
प्रपंच निर्माण विधिर्जया भवेत्
सचिन्तयन् द्व्यक्षरमेकदाम्बसि
सचिन्तयन् द्व्यक्षरमेकदाम्बसि
उपाश्रणोत् द्वीकृतं वचो विभू
उपाश्रणोत् द्वीकृतं वचो विभू
स्पर्शेषु यशोरशमेकविंशम्
स्पर्शेषु यशोरशमेकविंशम्
निष्किञ्चनानां नृपयद्धनं विदु
निष्किञ्चनानां नृपयद्धनं विदु
निशम्य तद्वक्तृदिदिक्षया दिशो
निशम्य तद्वक्तृदिदिक्षया दिशो
विलोक्य तत्राण्यदपश्यमान विलोक्य तत्रान्यतपश्यमानः
विलोक्य तत्रान्यतपश्यमानः
स्वधिष्ण्यमास्ताय विमृश्य तद्धितम्
स्वधिष्ण्यमास्ताय विमृश्य तद्धितम्
तपस्युपादिष्ट इवादधे मनः
तपस्युपादिष्ट इवादधे मनः
दिव्यं सहस्राब्दं मोख दर्शनो
दिव्यं सहस्राब्दं मोख दर्शनो
तितानि लाद्मा विदितो भयेन्द्रिय
तितानि लाद्मा विदितो भयेन्द्रिय
अतप्यतस्मत् अतप्यत
स्माखिल लोकतापनम्
अतप्यतस्माखिल लोकतापनम्
अतपतस्माखिल लोकतापनम्
तपस्तपीयांस्तपतां समाहितः
तपस्तपीयांस्तपतां समाहितः
तस्मै
स्वा
लोकम्
लोकम्
भगवान्
भगवान्
सभाजित
सभाजित
सन्दर्शयामास
सन्दर्शयामास
परम्
परम्
यत्परम्
व्यपेता
संक्लेशा
विमोहा साध्वसम्
स्वा
दृष्ट्या
वद्भिः
पुरुषैः
अभिष्टुतम्
तस्मै स्वलोकं भगवान् सभाजितः सन्दर्शयामास परं न यत्परम्
यपेत संक्लेश विमोह साध्वसम्
स्वदृष्टवद्भिः पुरुषैरभिष्टुतम्
transcendental vibration. So everything is there. If you do not practice, what can I do? The transliteration is there, the accent is there, and now our Pradyumna is there also. Utilize time and become attractive. As Krishna is all attractive, you become attractive at least to some. Krishna is all attractive. You cannot become all attractive. At least you become attractive to some. And they are becoming attractive by good apartment, by saving the beard or like that. You told me that they are trying to remain young.
Yes, yes. You've given us so many. Now we have so much to start. So many mantras, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, yes. Isha Upanishad.
Huge.
Yes.
So why are you not utilizing this facility?
We're missing the point.
Yeah. This evening you will have to chant these verses, and you will explain. That's all. Then I shall speak. First of all, let them hear from my disciples. Then I shall speak. Is that all right?
Yes, sir, Baba.
So you practice all day how to pronounce these slokas.
And all chant.
Yeah. And explain. Practice like this. Then wherever you go, you'll be all respected.
Tosmai city,
very nice. What is this? It is not even WC in comparison to the higher planetary building.
It's not even WC.
WC, toilet.
Huh?
Water closet.
WC.
What is called WC? What is
water closet. Mm-hmm. Huh.
Water closet.
That means laboratory.
Yeah.
Therefore the demigods do not come here even to urine. Formerly they used to come. Now they do not come because it is not fit for their urining. We are very much proud of our advancement. But the demigods do not come even to pass urine. Oh, why they should come? Now, because another house is raised here, even a common man is not coming to urine here. A little less facility, so they are not occupying. So why the demigods will come to this nonsense place? He can understand. These apartments are lying vacant on account of little less facility. So why the demigods? Their comforts and their standard of living is many millions times better than yours. You cannot imagine it. The more you go to the higher planet, his sister, their standard of living is still higher. Duration of life, standard of living, beauty, other facilities. Why is that called higher planetary system? Here in this planet, even you don't get the sun sign sufficiently. The bare necessities. Now you can experience that when you go above the cloud by aeroplane, you see there is no more cloudy. The sun sign is free. You can imagine how in the higher planetary system the sun sign is so free. And here, as soon as there is little sun sign, today, good morning, today is very good morning. In London, Lennon's, the gardener, he was meeting, I was walking, he has Mr. Johnson or something.
Frank.
So, Samuel, today is really good morning, yes. Otherwise it's dark. And actually, countries which has no sufficient sunshine, they're condemned. Mm. I told you frankly, your London is hell in the television. Actually, it is hell. We could understand from outside London. Simply dark, moist, everything damp. The trees, they have got what is called?
Moss.
Gathered moss for want of sufficient sunshine.
People get little relief from their misery and they say, oh, I'm happy now.
Yes. From the misery, Mr. John is happy by becoming naked and having water and fireplace. He's bringing the wood personally, putting there. And Joko is very happy. Japanese wife. She was talking philosophy with me.
And now he has made one song. I don't believe in Hare Krishna.
Who?
John.
He has made.
And that's all right. So our Hare Krishna will be advertised. People will be inquisitive. What is this Hare Krishna? At least. One who does not know. Oh, that's good.
Because nobody believes in John Lennon anymore either.
How long it will go bluffing?
Exactly. He's losing his
popularity.
Yeah. People are becoming disappointed. Because formerly he was a very brilliant songwriter, but now it's become very degraded. He formerly was married before, and he had family, I think, but then he divorced to marry.
Not divorced. The contract is her former husband should leave also. He has got double husband. He is living there along with him. I know that.
Cox.
Yes,
yeah, I mean.
He's living there.
Sanity.
Huh?
Simple insanity.
Saturday?
Insanity.
Insanity, yes. She's the manager. What manager? She has got a motorcycle and goes round. He must be given some post. And he has also married another.
Dan?
That.
I don't think he's legally married.
Friend. He has got a child?
One or two small children.
No. He has to maintain all of them. On this contract, the Joko is there.
Yes, Dan was her old friend.
Huh?
Dan was her friend. That's
yes.
Why he became manager.
So all this business on the basis of sex, that's all. Janama itana adi, griyame adi, sukhamme tucham. For very insignificant happiness that encumbered in so many ways. Janama itana adi, griyame adi, sukhamme tucham, kandriyane nakarayu, ribadukha dukham.
And every time she tries to have a child, because they lead such a decadent life, she has miscarriage every time.
That means she has got syphilitic wife.
Uh-huh.
Girls who cannot bear child means there is syphilitic wife. Mm-hmm. Either the man has got syphilitic poison or the woman has got syphilitic. And for these men, syphilis is not very uncommon.
In this country, it is now also very, epidemic.
Syphilis. All over Europe. When Dr. Bose is my friend, you saw him, he came to see me a lover.
Yes.
One doctor.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So, his friend, so he told me that when he was student, Cornell Mago, one big professor of medicine, he was lecturing, he was Englishman, he said that in our country, 70 to 80% of the student community, they are suffering from syphilitic attack. So, in our country, in India, if one is attacked with syphilis, then his taken as very abominable. His character is not good, it is understood. So, he said horrible, doctor goes, because he was Indian student. So, Colonel Mega replied, why you are saying horrible? So here, in your country, 90% people are attacked with malaria. I said, they are in syphilis. So as a medical practitioner, why you take this disease as bad and that disease as good? Your business is to see that there should be no disease. So don't consider this disease is good, this disease is bad. That's nice explanation. But 50 years ago, or 100 years ago, syphilitic poison was very much prevalent. Still it is in Europe and America. And now it is spreading all over. And in Ayurveda it is said, Phairanga. Phairanga. Firingi. The Europeans are described in Vedic literature as Firingi. Their name is Firingi. So the syphilis disease is mentioned in the Ayurveda. The disease brought by the Firingi. And the doctor says that originally it was spread through dog. The unmarried girls, they keep dog for sex. You do not know? You know. You will find many beautiful girls receiving very big dog. They are trained to have sex life. And that is cause of syphilis. The dog is full of syphilitic germs. It is called phairanga in the Ayurveda. And one who has got syphilitic germs, his life is doomed.
Yes.
Unless it is properly treated and cured, so many diseases will follow. So many. This craziness is also due to syphilitic poison. Parents.
There is a case of a very famous gangster, Al Capone, and others, they died in the prison house of syphilis in the on the mind, brain.
They see.
They went crazy.
So, how much by nature this sex life is condemned in so many ways? Therefore we say, no illicit sex. It will save you from so many encumbrances. Sex life is not denied, but this unrestricted sex life is very, very abominable in human society. But they are encouraged. Unrestricted sex life, they are distributing tablets, they are encouraging. All right, you have a sex life, never mind. Unmarried girls, they are keeping dogs. One lady in America, she told me that the dogs are kept for this purpose. When I was going to walk in that park in Brooklyn, the young girls are bringing dogs, big dogs. You are not at that time with me?
Yes. I don't remember.
Bhavananda was taking me to that big park.
Yes, I would. Prospect. Is it called Prospect?
Prospect Park, yes. Go on. Just try to understand the situation of the world. And we are living in this world. How much careful we have to become. Yes. Sankhya. These are the Sankhya. And Krishna showed him the Vaikuntha planet. Bapeta Sankhya. All these problems are not there. God.
Five kinds of material afflict Godhead, being thus very much satisfied with the penance of Lord Brahma, was pleased to manifest his personal abode, Vaikuntha, the supreme planet above all others. This transcendental abode of the Lord is adored by all self-realized persons freed from all kinds of miseries and fearfulness of illusory existence.
These five kinds of, it is explained there, five kinds of.
Five kinds of material miseries.
The material body is overcast with five kinds of miserable conditions, namely ignorance, material conception, attachment, hatred, and absorption. As long as one is overwhelmed with these five kinds of material miseries, there is no question of entering into the Vaikuntha lokas.
Another five kinds of misery is pavarga. Pa pa ba ba ma. Pavarga. And to counteract it is called apavarga. Apavarga vartmani. The pavarga, pa means purisham, hard labor. If you want to exist here, you have to work very, very hard. Much like this man with hard labor collected some money, constructed this house. Now there is no tenant, another hard labor to find out tenant. Is it not hard labor?
Yes.
In such an important city, these apartments are lying vacant. That means he's hiding. He has invited us to stay here to get some blessings so that tenants may come. Ashirvad, Ashirvad, he has.
Yes.
Aapko Ashirvad.
Ashirvad.
By the Ashirvad, he can get some tenants. All these men, they simply want Ashirvad. They don't want Krishna. They want Ashirvad so that their nefarious activities may continue. Peacefully.
Yes.
Impossible.
This Mr. Santana was the same. He had loaned to me some money for doing some work on the temple.
Mm.
And then when he got promotion in his job, he came to me and said, Sudama, it is by, the mercy of Krishna that I have now promotion. Please, do not bother paying me the money back.
That's nice.
Yes.
But difficulty sometimes, Krishna's Ashirvad may be just the opposite. Krishna's taker. So, at that time they become atheists. In Germany, there are so many atheists born out of the Second War.
In Japan also?
Japan.
Japan also. After the war, in Japan, during the war, the Japanese government supported a certain religious sect, Shinto religion, and they would spend thousands of dollars for ceremony, for soldiers and to have good omen for the war. When they lost the war, the entire government wrote in the Constitution, now it is in the Constitution, that the government of Japan will not support any religious organization. So the people then, after losing the war, they lost faith in anything religious. And they became distraught.
That is the effect of the last. People in general, they expect dharma for artha. Dharma for artha. The Bhagavad therefore explains the dharmasya. Dharmasya cha.
Dharmasya
hyapavargasya na arthayo artha upakalpate arthasya dharmaikantasya na kamalabhaya hismitaha. Yes. Dharmasya hi apavargasya na artha arthaya upakalpati. One should not execute religious principles for getting better financial or material facilities. That is not the purpose. But they are taking it for granted. But if we have supported this religious community, we must become victorious of our whimsical declaration of war. The Krishna supported the battle of Kurukshetra. It was not whimsical declaration of war. Before declaring war, Pandavas, even Krishna, tried to stop it in so many ways. When Duryodhan clearly said that not even that portion of land which can hold the tip of a needle can be given to you without war. They were, Krishna personally requested that they are Kshatriyas. They cannot take up the work of a Brahmin or a Shudra or a Vaishya. So better you give them 5 villages only. Let the 5 brothers rule over there. He replied, what do you say of 5 villages? And not that portion of land which can hold the tip of a needle, I can give them without war. And therefore the war was declared. All right, then decide by war. But that was not a whimsical war manufactured and maneuvered by the politicians. That is dharma yuddha. When you encroach upon my right, then must be tena taktena bhundita maghida kasati dharam. You cannot encroach upon others' right. So the animal killer, they are encroaching upon others' right. See this? Cows and goats, they are also living entities. They have got a right to live. When there is absolute necessity, that is a different thing. But you cannot encroach upon their right of living simply to satisfy the taste of your tongue. That is the greatest sin. Similarly, illicit sex. One has got wife and he is having illicit sex with other woman. That is the greatest crime. You want to satisfy your sex, all right, you have got legitimate wife. I know, I want to satisfy my senses. Therefore, illicit sex is sinful. You have got many other foodstuffs. Why should you satisfy your senses by killing some other right of living? Therefore, it is. Why it is sinful? Anyone can understand. That's why I have no money. That does not mean. To secure money, I said, take your money, then I am thief. You cannot say, oh, I have no money, this man has got so much money, therefore I have taken some money. Will the court excuse you? Even if you have no food, you cannot encroach upon others unless you are sanctioned. Therefore, according to Vedic system, the meat eater is given chance by sacrificing an animal before some demigod. Not free slaughterhouse, no, that you cannot do. Undergoing that process, someday he will come to his senses, this meat eating and killing of animal is not good. Because there are so many mantras, if you understand mantras, the mantra, when a goat is sacrificed before goddess Kali, before the goat being cut by his throat, the priest says, that because you are sacrificing your life before Goddess Kali, next life you are going to have human form of body for your dis-sacrifice. Otherwise, you have to undergo the process. There is gradual evolution in force. But because you are forced or somehow or other in the presence of mother material energy, she will give you the facility to promote immediately to the human form of life. And as human being, you will have every right to kill this man who is killing you. That is the meaning of Mangsa. Mam means me, Sa means he. He will also eat me. So I'll have to take the form of a goat next life, and he'll take the form of a human being, and he'll get the chance of killing me. He can excuse, but he'll get the chance. This is the bandhan. Karma bandhana. So after hearing all these mantras, if one takes the risk of eating me, let him do that. But who is that a sane man who will take this risk? This is the meaning of sacrifice. Not that it is a slaughterhouse substitute. No. They will understand that what kind of risk they are going to take by killing the animal under the name of sacrifice. Another thing is that to sacrifice the goat before the demigod Kali, it is restricted. Because the prescription is that one can sacrifice a goat before Goddess Kali on the dark moon night, Amavasya, or that is once in a month. So even the Shastra gives him the facility. The facility is restricted. As much as marriage. What is the difference between marriage, sex, and without marriage? When it is restricted, you restrict to one woman. You don't spoil many women and get syphilis disease. Is it? This is restricted. Restricted to one man, restricted to one woman, restricted once in a month. So actually, whenever there is sanction in the Shastra, that is not encouraging, that is restriction. So one cannot give this evidence, oh, you are Vedas, this is a sanction. But that sanction is restriction. Loki babayami samadvasi va nityasya jantu nahi tatra shodhana. This Shastra is not encouraging, because there is no need of encouraging. It is already known to him. Why this Shastra is encouraged? This is not encouragement. This is restriction. The same example can be given. Just like when government opens liquor shop, it is not encouragement. It is restriction. You cannot have liquor manufactured by yourself anywhere, everywhere. Otherwise it will increase more and more. So you have to pay heavy tax and purchase. And there are so many other rules and regulations. So this is restriction. When there is liquor shop licensed by the government, it doesn't mean it is encouragement. At least that is the philosophy. It is restriction. So all these facilities given sometimes in the Shastras or by the government for drinking or for intoxication or for sex or for gambling, that is restricted. This is gambling. The Kshatriyas, they can gamble. They must have the sporting spirit. Otherwise, when they are defeated, they will succumb to death. So they have to, the gambling, I lose $100,000. Never mind, it's sporting. Otherwise I will succumb to death.
Yeah.
I'll bring revolver, what? That is being done in gambling clubs.
Yeah.
But if you do it in a sporting habit, then never mind, again I lose, nothing, that's all. The Kshatriyas are allowed, because they when they fight, they'll have to gain or to lose. But if they lose, if they become succumb, then it will be very difficult for them. They are allowed to hunt. If they cannot kill, then how they will rule over the criminals? Kshatriya king, he's a criminal, just a parikrama, such a Vaishnava king. As soon as he saw somebody is trying to kill a cow, immediately took his sword. Why no nonsense you are doing? Immediately I shall kill you. A Kshatriya must be spirited, immediately, cut off. Even in England, that was the practice. They used to practice dummy, man, cut, right? The king must be like that.
Here also.
Huh?
Here also there king. Was a class of men called samurai. And they carried long sword and short sword. And if they had certain rules for fighting, they would never fight a man unless that he was equally matched.
Yes.
And if he lost, then he must take, if I lose the battle, then I must take the short sword and kill myself. For shame, for
not only dishonor. That, when Krishna was fighting with Rukmini's brother, see, he lost his chariot. And Rukmini took the sword, so Krishna also threw his bow and arrows, he also took the sword. Not that I shall possess better weapons to kill you, no, equal. Equal chance. If you have no sword, I'll give you a sword. Yes, take this sword. I take another sword. That is Kshatriya spirit, it's sporting. So for Kshatriya, this animal killing, this abomination, but they require.
Intoxication too?
Intoxication also. Just like Balaram, he was drinking madhu. Yes. You have not read it?
Yes.
He was also enjoying in the company of women. Because he's Kshatriya. The Kshatriyas are allowed. Polygamy. Drinking. Intoxication. Because they're king. They must have facilities. At the same time, they're ruling over the country, consulting great sages, saintly persons. And if he is not in order, these saintly persons will dethrone him. That is, Prithu Maharaj's father was killed, Ben. He was not according to the system. He was killed.
I don't understand how sometimes we how the intoxication or some type of wine would go along with the ruling of a country.
Well, for a ruler it is a pleasure. They must have some pleasure. Just like ordinary men, they drink with no man dancing. It is a recreation. So, this is material recreation. To be little intoxicated and several nice young girls around, that gives them some encouragement. You see? They have to take so much risk, so much responsibility. If for recreation they require it. They should be given little facility.
Can they still make spiritual advancement?
Spiritual advancement is going on. They are taking advice from great saintly persons. They are observing these, they are performing great big sacrifices, spending money, treasury. That is a spiritual advancement. They are satisfying Krishna. In spite of all these devatas, the demigods, they also enjoy. In a high planet system, like Indra, he is a prostitute hunter number one. Indra. But he is a great devotee at the same time.
But he's still in the material world.
Yeah, this is material. So those who are going to directly to transfer to the spiritual world, for them all these things are private. But those who want to remain here, at the same time they have got some particular duty, these are also. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, those who are preparing Bhagavad Bhajanon Mukhasya Nishkinchana, they must give up all these things. They should be Nishkinchana. Nishkinchana sar jadhanam vidu. You have read that. Devotee, they don't want all this, anything, any glaring position, even Brahma. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says that Brahma janme nahi maras. I don't care for to take birth as Brahma. Kita janma ho jatha tuva das. Better let me become an insect where your devotee is there. So our purpose is different. We don't want even the exalted place like Brahma in this material world. We don't want. That is our intent. We want Krishna. Go back to home, back to God.
Could these enjoyments of the
Shakti... Param na jat param. What is that? But param na...
Jat param.
Jat param.
Samdarshi yamasa param na jat param.
Param, we are seeing here in this material world. This apartment is better than the down apartment. So it is param. Param means better, superior quality. So here in this material world, we are finding out something superior than the other. Because it is relative world. But the kingdom of God, Vaikuntha, Najat param, there is no param. Finish, all param finish.
Nothing is superior than which.
Yeah. Param, you can say, it is a very nice apartment. Especially after Vaikuntha. But he has no idea. He thinks that if I go to Europe, I get a better standard of living, better woman. And with a salary. But he has no idea what is param. Therefore, it's a param, not that param. There is no all superior. All superior, finish. This is Bhagavad. Param, not just param. Final. Final beauty, Krishna. Final opulence. Final strength. Final wisdom. Everything final in Krishna, ultimate. Nama, Najat Param. Therefore, it's called Parameshara. Ishara means commander. There are many things, commander, the controller. But Krishna is called Parameshara. Nama. And Krishna said, Matta Parataram Nanya. Param means superior. There is no more superior than me. Parangana jatapam. This is meaning. So have Sankirtan.